Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. We're talking about dermal fillers. What are your options? I'm going to go through them, talk about the different types, talk about what are the options most people choose, why they choose them, what should you choose, what makes sense for you. It depends on what we're trying to achieve. Angles, do you want a full face rejuvenation? You want short term? You want long term? What's your provider really good at doing? What type of fillers are they used to doing? That will determine it. We have permanent products. I have a video I did recently on bellafill. A lot of people ask, hey, how come things don't last longer? I'm going to succinctly as I can take you through the types of dermal fillers that are commonly used. I'll touch on some that are available in just a few countries maybe, but we're going to stick with what's commonly available in most countries, why people choose them, and what's right for you, starting in 3 seconds. So there's so many choices out there. Part of what we do with this channel is take the confusion out of it, or at least educate so you can figure out what you might want to do. I'm going to, in a very quick fashion for each one, run through some of the possibilities and what may make you choose one versus another. And everyone's psychology is a little bit different. Some people want things in their body they know is going to go away. Other people want things that are permanent. They want implant type of products. And other people want something in between. And just because you want a certain look or you want something that lasts a long time but is ultra safe and never has a problem, it might not exist. So we'll talk about it. Remember, if you like the videos, click like. We've had tremendous growth on the channel. I appreciate it. It allows me to do more. When you like, it steps up our videos, more people see them, we grow. In the comments section, I let them run. Unless there's something that's erroneous, I'll pipe in and talk about. I try and respond to everyone if you have questions. Some of the questions it's impossible for me to answer, as you could imagine, because I don't have enough information, but the comments are important. So when you see like our Ulthera video where people are commenting about the problems they've had, the successes they've had, these are real world answers, and hopefully it helps us all learn and educate, which is why we're here. So subscribe and like it. On to fillers. So let's start with the most common type of fillers. First of all, way back when I started, we had collagen. Didn't last, hard to find. It is embedded in bellafill, which I have a whole other video if you're interested in permanent or long-term. But, and I will talk about it in this video quickly, but the most common done around the globe are hyaluronic acid fillers. And there's so many. Most people know the Juvederm family, the Restylane family, we have Bellatero, there's Versa. So there's different ones that have different properties and characteristics. But hyaluronic acid, I did a video on hyaluronic acid skincare. That's how many of us know it. That's not cross-linked. So that if you were to inject that product, it's often microneedled in, it'll last 3 to 5 days at most in the body, and it's gone. Fillers, hyaluronic acid fillers are cross-linked. It's why I'm skeptical, and I have a whole video on the hyaluron pen or Hyapen, because a lot of people are putting in superficially non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid, which is gone pretty quickly. When you do go to the cross-link product, now it's placed superficial, and there's been a lot of problems. People who have clinics, real clinics, see real problems. They're going to tell you they're dissolving a lot of Hyapen problems because you have to put these type of fillers a little deeper so they don't have a tindle or blue looking effect. And the Hyapen has a variable depth depending on the skin type and many factors. But that's hyaluronic acid. The benefits, they contour. They're dissolvable. So if you don't like it, you get rid of them. The downside is there's six different types of hyaluronidases, which is what we use, hyaluronidase or Hylenex type products, to dissolve the products. Naturally, our body has them at differing levels. So some people will wear them off quick. They last way longer than the studies show. So I can make a study that shows all of them pretty much to last 6 months or 2 years, because it's how the study is designed, what we look for. We're looking for often a facial assessment scale in the study, whereas if you watch my video of my PRF under eye, when I did my under eyes, 5 years ago, I had them done with hyaluronic acid. Each year it would come a little to the surface, I dissolve a bit, I was pretty happy with it, finally dissolved it all, went to doing PRF, I'm in the midst of that, watched that video. So that's not a filler, that's your blood product. But the hyaluronic acid, part of the problem is it draws water in. It lasts a long time. So sometimes we do need to dissolve them. You get migration, which is why we dissolve lip filler. You can watch my videos on that. But the hyaluronic acid families, and when we talk about them, there's over 200 hyaluronic acid fillers in Europe. So when you guys from around the globe are asking me questions about them, a lot of times I can't answer because people don't know what's been put in their body. If you're looking for price point, or you've paid quite a cheap price for your filler, a lot of times you don't know the depth it's placed, but you might not know what it is. It might not be what you think. It happens more than not. There's cases of people injecting products with toxins that actually had permanent filler in them, and all these little bumps occurred where they were given the toxin, so the Botox or Dysport, when in fact there's PMMA in there. So, you know, we see it all, and we see all what people call botched or all the problems. So when people think they're getting a filler, if it was a price point, sometimes they're not getting what they think. It's very common. How would you know? Think about yourself. You go to a clinic, I'm buying Restylane. I go to a clinic, I'm buying Restylane. I got a great deal, it's $300. I know that's the cost of the product. It probably isn't it. I don't know, it could be in the same vial, looks the same. I think I'm getting Restylane in my face. It could be bioalkermit, a long-term to permanent product from Europe that I can get very inexpensively. So you understand the breadth of the problem, but there's hyaluronic acid products, some of the benefits and the downsides. Number two, we get into, if we're still going on fillers, we go to kind of biostimulator filler would be, say, radiesse, which is calcium hydroxyl apatite, which has carboxymethylcellulose in 70% of the syringe, 30% is that calcium component. There's typically 1.5 cc syringes, although you can get different sizes. So people like it because hyaluronic acid comes in a 1 ml typically. Now they're getting more, they're getting 1.5 times, maybe for the same price, but understand, 3/4 or 70% of that syringe is a filler that's gonna go away in 2 to 3 months. Not a bad thing, not a negative, but you're gonna get that power effect. You might get that disappointment in 2 to 3 months, but you're getting that biostimulator or calcium that stimulates your own long-term collagen. Very different product, not dissolvable. There's places you wouldn't put it. For me, the lip, the under eye would be places. It's very nice in the hands, the cheeks, jawlines are great because it has a high G prime. You better think of calcium, like a phone, it's strong, it has punch, okay? So it's an element, of course, calcium is. So you can form things, you can get nice contours. That's the benefit of it, and it helps stimulate your own collagen. So that would be a calcium type of filler. Let's go to the next biostimulator you know I love, Sculptra. PLLA, that is in different countries, you find it in different mediums. So it could be the PLLA molecule could be found embedded in hyaluronic acid. In this country, many countries, what Sculptor, it comes as a powder-like product. And then we mix typically a water type of product with it, either water, sodium chloride, different things, but a liquid. And then we inject it. Now, many people asking this question in this channel, what about PDO, polydioxinone, or the threads, PCL, polycaprolactone, or the thread type that's in kind of like Sculptor mixed in a water, you mix it up, you'll see, if you watch my video on powdered or liquid PDO threads, I think I called it, you can watch it. But that's also a biostimulator, but it's not PLLA, it would be the PDO, or the PCL would be the active ingredient. See how this gets confusing? Sculptor is one of probably the most predictable, best collagen builder that I know of in a vial. And the benefit of it is water is the carrier. So when you're going to get your hyaluronic acid filler, I can contour you, I can make lips, I can make a jawline with it, I can give you chin projection. But imagine if I could blanket your face with a collagen stimulator and I can treat your whole face. Because you tell me, who wants half a face treated? I'll tell you, the young people. Because their skin looks good, they're looking for projection. Great, hyaluronic acid. If they draw water in their under eye, not a big deal. A darker person, skin type 4 and above, or a younger person with good skin, a lot of times you might not see the water, the HA filler, hyaluronic acid filler, is drawing in. However, if you take something like what I do is plasma sculpt, concentrations of PLLA and your blood product, platelet-rich fiber, watch my videos on that. I treat the whole face, and at the same time, I can treat the lip and hair growth above the brow, things like that, because no one comes, very few people except the under 30 category, and even them, will come to the clinic and say, I just want part of my face treated. It makes no sense. If you're over the age of 40 or 50, you want the whole face treated. Why have a young looking lip or a young looking cheek or a chin projection when the rest of the face has lost collagen? There's vertical lip lines, smoker's lines, there's loose skin around the edge of the mouth. Nobody wants that. They're doing it because hyaluronic acid fillers are the most common. They're dissolvable, they're quick to do, they're available. But combining it with or going to a biostimulator for most people after the age of 40, for me and my practice, is paramount. Everyone, this is not to say everyone needs to do that. I'm giving you opinion. It's my channel. It's our channel. That's why you're coming here. But educating you on biostimulators versus the fillers. Let's go to something long-term and permanent. And for a complete discussion on bellafill, which is PMMA, polymethyl methacrylic acid, you can go to my video on that. But it's long-term. There's five-year data on it. Now, that's what the company can say because that's where the study went to. Just like the nasal fold study showing something lasts 18 months, it's studied, but the filler here might last 2 to 5 years, 7 years. It could still be there easily. Hyaluronic acid filler. So the company can only say 5 years, but PMMA does not dissolve. It's long lasting. It's the longest lasting. It's in there permanently. Some people want, they come into the clinic, they'll say, I don't want anything to do with something that doesn't last long term because it's cost effective to have something that lasts long term. Now, there are side effects specific to something that's in there full time. And you can't remove it if you don't like it. And some may say the face might change, which is why I don't use that type of product under the eye, because there's so many changes. Skin, fat, and bone around the eye. And the eye is in the window where people are very particular about what they see. It's why I use PRF or platelet-rich fibrin before any filler under the eye, because it's your own body's product. You see how we all have our own art of doing this. Not one way is right. I'm not right. It's not my way. It's what I do for my patients. It's what they like. It's why they come to me. You have your own provider and have the reasons why you go to them and you like them as well. I'm giving you the information. So for a filler like PMMA, understand that it's very long-term. It's the longest lasting. I will note there's a safety factor with long-term. The more you get injected, if you have to come in every year for your injections, you take the risk of necrosis, blindness, the bad things. I have videos on those if you want to see fillers gone wrong or what can go wrong with fillers or PDO threads. You can watch those videos. But understand, a temple, take a temple. Who wants to come and get that filled every year with a hyaluronic acid? It's why most people don't fill the temple. But now if you had a permanent solution like fat from your body, a long-term solution like Sculptra, or a permanent solution like bellafill, especially if fat didn't work, bellafill is a great option because you do, I'd say, 2 sessions, maybe 5 to 8 vials, you're probably done for your life in your temple. You probably don't have to do it again. For my patients, once they've had bellafill, I might then add some Sculptra to lift the edge of the eye, give that towel around the head lift every few years, but pretty much they're done at the temple. And the temple is an area that a lot of people don't bring it up when they go in to get their fillers because people are scared to do it, and rightly so. If you're using a microcannula and a hyaluronic acid in the filler, hyaluronic acid filler in the temple, and you're doing it every year, just by the fact that you're having a needle put in your temple with a filler once a year, once every 2 years versus once in your life, there's a safety balance factor that you and your provider need to make. For me, it's kind of a no-brainer. But my patients obviously think like me, and that's why they come to me. And everyone will have their type of patient and patient profile. So those are the main type of fillers. Now, I didn't talk about bioalkylamid. I didn't talk about silicon. They don't apply to a lot of people. There's some other classes of fillers maybe I missed. If there are, put it in the comments. I don't want to make these too long, but I do want to educate you on all that's commonly out there. Join me here. Subscribe. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.